Hello, hello, hello. I hope everyone is having a fabulous day. I'm excited to be here because I have finally finished my book and I'm delighted to share it with you. Here's a book. It's very similar to how I showed it to you before, but I've just added a few different little things. I've changed to a ribbon for my binding area because I like the look better. It's nice to use these while I was making it, but I don't like the look when it was finished, so I switched it out. Back I still kept very simple, and there's just a little view of my side. As we turn the pages, you're going to see in the front pocket I have the quote that my book is based upon. It's Philippians 4:8, and it says, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, and it goes on, and it's about being able to focus your mind on the things that are good instead of pondering the things that aren't so good. So on my page here, I've got this darling little bird. I've got all these little things that pull out, these little tucks. Makes it just a little fun. As I turn the page, you're going to see some other little tuck areas. I'm going to try to go fast for you and just not explain too much because you can just see what it is. I've got a card. Switches. I've tried to keep the next pages plain just for journaling. I did coffee dye all my paper, but I like adding color to it. So you'll see a pink glow throughout the book, and you also see down the pages. I'll show you later. So on the next three pages, I kind of carry the theme of the little birds throughout it. Did a little stenciling, and I added the pink and the white highlights. Next page here, I've got honorable. Put a cute little picture there. Added Tim Holtz things. It's just amazing at the end when you add little things like that. It just makes a nice difference. So I've got a little tuck here once again, and you can see these are the book pages from the initial pages that I ripped out. And you can see how I mostly color over them, but I just leave little areas that are peeking out. So I want it to be interesting, but I don't want it to take away and for you to just feel like you need to read the words. Here's a doily that I made into a little flip. I Mod Podged it so it's movable. So I turn the page, and I tried to keep it as plain as possible so it doesn't get too thick, and also just so it's more about writing and not about all the things that I put in it. So I have the pinks, I have the little areas that I've added to it. The next page, it's just, and I have a few little tucks here. Little fabric that I stapled onto that one. A fabric belly band. As I turn the page here, this is actually a tea bag that I was able to glue on. I really like the look of it. It's a really grungy look. It's free, and it just adds a nice, feel to it. Different texture. Some more coffee dyed paper with the pink, some little Tim Holtz accents. I've got them all throughout the book. Little card that I added some stuff to. And I just carried the theme of the flowers through these pages. On the next page here, this is pure, and this is a stamp that I've had for probably 15 years, which I just love. It's just a sweet little stamp. So I created like a little purple berry going through these pages here. Got various little tucks coming out. And places to journal. Once again, I just kind of carry the pink smudges going on. And the next page here, I've got lovely, and I've kind of put roses and kind of just a shabby chic type look to it. And as you see throughout, I've used different fabric things to make tabs out of. This one, this just pulls out. Oops, let me. I found it stayed on better if I just put a clip there, so I did that. So I put the little crepe ribbon, extra little piece. I find that, and you know, maybe you do too, if I have a rougher piece of paper in the back, it stays in a little better too. So anyway, just a little thing, little detail. So this was made out of wax paper, and I have a tuck in there, little washi tape going along the edge. Makes it fun. This tape, I mean not tape, this tag. This says she had a feeling. So I've got other little embossing parts. These are made out of the little crinkled paper, party paper kind of stuff. Fill the tags right here. I made that one. And then that one. I love these pink roses. I love the look of that. And just, this is a fabric tuck that I made. A little pocket. So little pieces went in there. And this actually comes out also. Another little tuck. This is what's commendable. I actually like how this turned out. I was really struggling with it, but I'm happy with it. So another little fabric piece that I put on there for the tab. This is a Prima paper. You may recognize some of you. Some little tucks. Feathers. I like putting little things around. Here's a piece of... This is actually a... oops, got a little glue there. This is a coffee filter, believe it or not. I ordered the wrong kind of coffee filter, so I thought, well, I'm going to use this then for my junk journals. And a little tuck there. A little tuck here. Another Tim Holtz flower. Some lace that I cut and placed. Now this right along here, this is made from little paint samples. I cut strips and then I punched holes in it. So I just used some of the things that I had. A little card. Envelope, not a card. A little tuck spot here. I love that lace. It opens up. Excellent. Another little fabric. This was actually from a pair of shorts that I got at a thrift shop. It was a little girl's pair of shorts, and it has this little embroidery on it. I did some embroidery myself for some stitching I was going to use, but I liked just the miscellaneous better, so I used that. A great use of 50 cents. Here's another page, and you can see a little bit more how you can see through into the... Hopefully you can see that. See into the words, but it's just covered up with the pink. In this case, I used paint. So here's a vellum envelope. With a little tuck that I made. A little card. I'll put it aside. So a little nice emblem. This is a vintage card that I just got for free at a yard sale. A little Tim Holtz card. Little tuck birdies. So some more pages. This is just some baking paper. I like using that just to create a little texture and movement. Tim Holtz butterfly. So this also, this is the new Tim Holtz 3D embossing folder, and I made this. This is actually a paint swatch also, so I cut it from that. It worked out great. Over here is another one, but I used the back side, and so if you look, you can actually see the words and the lettering, but I decided to keep it on this side rather than painted side because it gave it just a little bit more of a rustic feel, kind of like that bird nest feel where you're just pulling things that don't really belong, but you make it belong. So I kept that. I liked it. Little birdie from Tim Holtz, praiseworthy, whatever is praiseworthy, think on that. So I put a little piece of music in there, another one of these little tucks that I made. Made a music pocket. This is some of the Tim Holtz paper. This is the first time I've ever used that, his wallpaper paper. Some just little tucks of my coffee dyed paper. Here's a little charm that I added on there. Couples, just simple little tucks. My goal for this book was really just making places that I can write. I normally just fill them up so much with a lot of different things. This one flips open so I can write on those pages. And this one has just a few different pieces that are put together. This one's pulled out. And I just like this spunky girl at the end.